is a Piccadilly line service to Cockfosters.
Thank you. locations as such. I want to talk about design generally, and particularly with the road and rail vehicles. It's all about how you can get people on and off quickly. Spiral elevator. So apart from the lifts, in 1911 they had the first escalator, and an escalator can move 7 times more people than you can in a lift, so that's a good thing to have. This was two sort of helix structures. It was almost like an Archimedes screw, and it didn't work. Mm. They found it at the bottom of Holloway Road underground lift shafts. And you think if it's doing something like that, like an Archimedes screw, it just kind of throws you out the top, which is not a good thing.
It's so nice to see, isn't it? It's incredible.
Yes. The whole system evolved. Originally steam trains, train cars. When you started getting electric power, you had motor units. Here, this is where they would have had the guard, who's operating the doors here. And if you come along where I am, you can see a little attachment of the uprights. Locomotive. So this literally said so much of this system is above ground. When they were expecting adverse weather, they literally run an antifreeze tank up and down. This is what it is. You've got brushes, you've got jets down, and you can see it here. It's all it is, just loads of antifreeze. And again, basic inside. But what they do, these would be powered by a battery. They'd run up and down, pushing whatever was needed to wherever it went. And then when they went back in the depot, they would charge it up, ready for the next run. Interestingly, these buffers are variable. You can actually put them up on there. I don't think I'd like to do that, really. this is one of our success stories. On the underground, if you look at the map and you know your way around, runs between Waterloo and Banks, a one-stop shuttle. The only way you can get the vehicles in there is a big crane, which will literally drop them down onto the track. And you've seen all around, you've been looking at the roundel, you've been looking at the signage that we have, and here, something completely different. This is what was called Network Southeast, and when they brought in this new modern signage, who were perhaps more cynical said they don't know which way they're going, but it's meant to sort of be the track direction and so on. When this came in, it was in a poor condition, and it's been hand-painted and renovated. And really, they decided to have it in the southeastern railway. It's now part of the tube system again. Interestingly, some of this sort of train, when it finishes with London Transport, has a life, not just in here, but the Isle of Wight, the island of Portsmouth and South.
Waterbury Town. This is a Piccadilly line service to Rayners Lane.
Customers are reminded that smoking is not permitted on any London Underground station or train.